I'm going to do a video of how to check out and repair the cruise control on the early GM cars that had the vacuum actuator. And first I'm going to demonstrate the problem, the symptom. And then I will go through the actual repair, what to do to fix this problem. And I'm going to get out on the highway where I can get it up to speed and try to engage the cruise and show what the symptom is. Okay, now I'm moving down the highway. And I don't know if the light's going to show up, but I'm going to set the cruise. You can see right there the cruise light's on. But you can also see that the car's slowing down, even though the cruise light's on. And we got a massive amount of vacuum because it's just at idle. I mean, if I touch the pedal at all, you see what happens. The cruise itself is just simply not working, and as soon as I get back to the barn, I will show what's causing this problem, how to troubleshoot it, and how to fix it. Very often this cruise problem develops slowly. You'll notice one day that you set the cruise at 80 on the freeway and it slows down maybe to 70, but it keeps working. But it works okay at lower speeds, and then you set it at 55 on the highway and find out that it slows down to 40, 45, and eventually it doesn't work at all. Like this one's reached a stage where, as you saw, it doesn't really work at all. What's happening is this rubber part is the vacuum diaphragm, and you see if I press it in, it works the cable just like the gas pedal. And it has a supply here of vacuum. It's always got vacuum on this tube, and that goes all the way back and tees in with the air conditioner vacuum. And then underneath the car, on this car, I think it's over on this side, there's a vacuum reservoir, which you may not be able to see up in there. Kind of a round ball thing. And also, there is a check valve where engine vacuum is provided. Let's see if I can find it, to all this stuff. Yeah. See if the camera will focus that black thing right there. It's kind of cone-shaped on one end, has two lines on the other. But it has a manifold vacuum supply that goes through some steel tubing, and then on this engine it comes up to here. And anytime the engine's running at idle or at less than full throttle, there's vacuum drawing all the air out of that the vacuum storage tank. And then it uses that as its energy supply to run the cruise. Now, when the cruise has to accelerate the car, say you're going up a slight hill or something like that, the engine has no vacuum. So it's depending on the check valve and the vacuum reservoir to maintain vacuum at all times for this. And if it doesn't maintain vacuum, then your car will only be able to work on level ground and cruise. It won't go up any hills without slowing down. And the engine's been shut off for a few minutes. And I'm going to try to change the air conditioner mode and listen carefully. You hear the mode door changing? So it still has vacuum after the engine's been stopped a few minutes. So that tells me my check valve is good and there's no major leaks in the system, in the vacuum system. I'm going to start it up again. See, at idle it has a lot of vacuum in the manifold, and it uses that to charge up the vacuum tank. Then the minute the engine stops, it loses its vacuum, but the check valve and the vacuum reservoir should maintain it for the cruise. When I pull this off, you should hear suction. So the car's accessory vacuum system is working fine. That tells me that something inside this the servo is not working right. And my car is being invaded. So we'll get this servo off of here and we'll tear it down and troubleshoot it. Now this cap here is something I don't have hooked up on this car, but I'll explain it on another car. Okay, I moved to another car. This big hose, so I can get it off without breaking it. This is a secondary cruise release system. And that hose goes to a valve on the brake pedal, and if you step on the brake, it just opens a vent valve. It lets air rush in and release the vacuum from the diaphragm. And it's kind of an optional thing in my opinion, because if you step on the brakes, you're turning off electric power to this. And also if you turn off the cruise switch, you turn off electric power. And when this opens up, it releases it really fast, and that's hard on the engine, on the turbo engine. So I prefer to have that capped off on mine. But you can clearly see the check valve, that part right there. And this tube, two tubes come off of it. This one goes over here to the cruise directly. This one here goes to the air conditioner. And then it continues on over there. You see it moving. And goes to the vacuum reservoir. And then on the 3300 engine, it's easy to see how it works, because here's your supply directly into the manifold. So that should explain that a little better. Now get on with the repair. Okay, I got the servo here on the bench, and if I'm not mistaken, the only tool you'll need to tear it down is a T15. And I've got the camera zoomed in pretty close, so if I go off screen, I'm sorry. I may zoom it out once I get some of it apart, so I'm not constrained to such a small work area. But one thing you got to remember, there are some small parts in this that are easy to lose. And if you lose anything out of it, you got to get a whole new one, because no parts are available. The first thing to take off is this cover. And now you can get an idea of how this actually works. There's two solenoid valves, a vacuum valve and a vent valve. And as soon as you turn on the cruise, this one closes and it blocks the air inside there like that. And that lets it release the throttle. And this other one, engine vacuum draws air out from there whenever this is actuated, and it causes this to suck in. But the problem is, down inside this base right here, there's a little air filter made of foam. And that foam deteriorates, and the pieces of the foam get in this valve. And it just has a small amount of force when it pulls down. So if there's any foam stuck in there, it pulls down a little bit weakly, which is all it should normally need, but it's not enough to close that valve off. So it's always leaking. And then all the vacuum in the system is lost. So the cruise gets weak, and this comes back out, and the car slows down. So we'll go ahead and take the rest of this apart. Those windings there are kind of a sensor, magnetic sensor. It doesn't have anything to do with this problem. But we'll just keep taking the screws out. Make sure I'm on screen still. And then this, that plunger, that's what usually gets lost. And then that pin in there is also easy to lose. That stuff on screen where you can see all the parts. But the pin and the magnetic plunger can fall out and be lost, and if you lose it, like I said, you're going to be going to the junkyard to find another one. Retainer. Now this is where it gets tricky. The little magnet wire, these solenoid coils are permanently attached by magnet wire. And if you're rough with them, you'll break that magnet wire, and then you've ruined your unit and you're done. If that happens, go to the junkyard and get a new one if you can't solder it. But you're just now able to see the little remains of the foam filter down in there. And that thing, it should come out of there. Not sure what's holding it. I'm going to take it off camera for a second. I'm going to pause the camera and come right back. I know what's wrong. There's an O-ring in there that's stuck. And I'm going to go carefully pry it out. I'll be right back. Okay. I just carefully went under there and pried that up where this the valve body comes off. And there's your diaphragm. That, nothing wrong with that. And another thing to note, that orifice right there, that sets the response of the cruise control. If it's always making too large of an adjustment, let's say for instance you change your engine and you put a really, really big engine, it only takes a tiny, tiny amount of pedal to maintain speed, you can change that to a smaller size and it'll reduce the amount of large corrections the cruise is making. But right now I just want to repair this where it works right again. So I'm gonna lay the coils to the side, and I don't want to keep bending the little wires until they break. So I'm gonna try to just lay them to the side like that. Take this off, and you see here, I'm gonna zoom in on that. No, won't focus. Well, I'm not a good videographer. That the crumbly stuff, that was a filter. And it just turns to dust. And then those pieces of it get caught underneath this little rubber ball. You see the crumbs of that stuff on the rubber ball? And anything that gets between the end of that, get it on the screen there. Anything that gets between the end of that rubber ball and that seat will cause a vacuum leak, and then your cruise is going to lose speed gradually. So I'm going to clean these parts up and come back in a minute. Okay, I took a vent filter for a heating system vent, and I cut a strip of it to make a cruise control filter, vacuum filter. And I will put it in to the actuator where the original foam filter was. Just wrap it around like so. Trying to recreate what the factory had in there the best I can. And I don't know what the temperature rating of this material I'm using is, but it was intended for a heating vent to put inside the heating vent, so it should withstand the underhood temperature. If not, then I'll have to find something better. But I will say this, I've been cutting off of that sheet for years. That's probably 2 or 3 years old, and I haven't had any repeat failures. So it appears to me that it's close enough to the temperature rating that it's holding up. Now I'll try to zoom back in on it. All right. Now the vent valve spring. I want to make sure there's not dirt and debris, pieces of the old filter still on it. So I cleaned it up. And I cleaned the parts with the electrical contact cleaner and air. I want to make sure there's nothing stuck on that ball that's going to contaminate the seat. And that is corroded, but it's clean, so there's nothing to come off and clog the system. So we'll put that back on. Once again, everything, I'm trying to be careful not to damage the little wires that connect the solenoid coils. There's a little more dirt there I want to clean off. Some more traces of that old filter. All right, and there's a spring washer there. Keep checking to make sure I'm still on screen on the camera. This is slightly easier to do when you're not trying to video it, but to me it's worth it to help other folks to solve their problems. So you know, it takes longer, it's worth it. So we're getting there.
Now there's one screw that goes in this top. Go ahead and put that in. Unlock that.
That gets it together where it's going to protect those little fine magnet wires from getting pulled too much.
And then the pin for the vent valve, the plunger, feels like it's working.
Now this has got an O-ring around it here where it seats into the diaphragm.
So I'm going to go off screen and I'm going to come back in a minute and I'll have some silicone gel in there to lubricate that.
Okay, got a little silicone gel in there to help it go together. See where the O-ring. Autofocus on this camera. I guess I've got it zoomed in too far. Doesn't like that. That's better. That's it. Back together.
A couple of screws in there. GM liked their T15. Now, since this car, I have capped off this secondary release port, I'm going to go get a new cap and put on that. The pin and the plunger fell out. That's why I recommend working on a good workbench, because it was easy to find. It fell out of there. So I'll be back in a minute with the cap. Okay, got the cap on there. I'm going to put back in the pin and the plunger that fell out. Now, earlier I did this test and it stayed in, but I was pushing really, really hard on that. So I'm just going to push that gently. Just enough to hold it as if it were the electromagnet, and it's staying. If I release it, you can make small adjustments, but for the most part, simulate vacuum. If I hold that even gently, it'll stay. If I had a vacuum source on there, I could apply power to that one and make it draw back in, but I'm going to trust that that one's going to work. So this is what keeps this from falling out in use. So put this back on, and the plunger and pin can't fall out. And then the last two the screws go in there. Now, go put it back on the car and take it for another test drive. This thing is retained by three bolts in these holes here. They go through the bracket, and it just takes a 7mm socket, little 7mm socket to put them back. Very easy job. And that's it, she's back. I've got the vacuum supply. The secondary release port, if you had that tube on there, or a cap in my case. Electrical plug. The throttle cable clip is on, and you can move it by hand and the throttle's working. So yeah, it looks like ready for a test drive. Okay, back out on the highway, about 55, and I'm gonna try the cruise control.
Watching the camera, I'm just trying to show you. Just maintaining speed, and see, it shows 10 inches of vacuum, which is, or less. That's kind of like, you know, going down the road vacuum, not throttle closed. Now to the accelerate button. It's strong too. I mean, it pushes me back in the seat. Accelerate up.
Well, I was
going to demonstrate the resuming function of the cruise, but because we're in beautiful rural central Alabama, I'm behind a combine harvester up there ahead and then being followed by a pickup truck. So I think at this point I'm going to show it enough to demonstrate the cruise is working, and I think I'm going to conclude the video and call this one a wrap. And I plan to do a future video going over the electrical side of the cruise control. So we'll look forward to that. And once again, this is the South, the people are courteous, and so he's gonna pull off like that and let everybody around. So I hope this video helps you guys to troubleshoot and repair these vacuum cruise actuators, and not always have to pay for a new one each time something goes wrong. Virtually every one of these older cars that I've restored or had to work on had this problem with the deteriorated filter foam getting into the solenoid valve. If you fix that, cruise will pretty well work like new. Talk to y'all later.